Nobody knew Ronda Blaylock quite like her mom, Rebecca Lynn, better known simply as Lynn.
She was such a sweet and kind person.
But Ronda spent a lot of time with the rest of her family too, like her first cousin, Sherry Thigpen.
We would often spend the weekends at my grandparents' house and just play out in the woods, play blocks, listen to music.
Ronda was an only child and was spoiled like one.
I mean, she had everything in her room. She had all the latest Barbie dolls and the music and everything.
Lynn made most of Rhonda's clothes by hand. Sherry got her hand-me-downs. Ronda would also pass down what she was experiencing as a young teenager to her cousin, who was 2 years younger.
I was more innocent probably than she was, and she'd tell me about kissing boys and stuff like that. And I just was kind of in awe of that because that was all foreign to me.
Ronda had been a Girl Scout growing up in a private Christian school, a latchkey child at a time where keys often weren't needed to get into homes in a town like Rural Hall.
She would get off the school bus, go in and change out of her school clothes into her play clothes, for lack of a better term, and wait on her mom or her dad to get home from work.
It was a sense of safety, security, that was enjoyed by most school children in 1980.
You know, we were allowed to walk by ourselves back and forth to the swim club, you know, walk just about anywhere we wanted to by ourselves.
But that would soon change as Ronda was going through changes of her own.
It was either the last year or 6 months prior to her going missing that started public school. And she met a whole new group of friends.
40 years later, one of her old friends, Tammy Worrell, remembers the last times she saw Ronda.
I saw her 3 weeks before she passed.
Still holding on to their youthful exuberance.
She loved Michael Jackson. And back then, he had just came out with his new album, and she had gotten it. And we had our own little dance party the weekend she got the new record. Spent the weekend together.
They may have thought, okay, she's just a runaway. She'll be home in a couple of days.
The purity of childhood would soon be stripped away when Ronda's partially clothed body was found on August 29th, 1980.
Kind of changed your innocence a little bit.
One of Ronda's new friends was the last to see her as she pulled off in a 1970s model blue pickup with a man investigators only knew as Butch or Jimmy.
You think New York City or L.A. or somewhere like that, you're in danger, but I guess you're just as much in danger here as anywhere.
We would later learn that Jimmy was a good guess.
And his dad beat him and mistreated him.
35 years later, it would take people from 12 different agencies and organizations to take it from theory to conclusion.
If he did do it, something happened that night.